A warning now. Some viewers may find scenes in our first story upsetting. A Hamilton dairy worker is in hospital after having fingers severed during another violent dairy robbery. The owner says the man was trying to get away from the machete-brandishing attacker. Te Anua Huri Hanganui with this report.
It was a typical Saturday morning at this Hamilton dairy until four men pulled up and ran inside. As this worker tried to flee, he was attacked by a machete-wielding offender.
He ran in here to save himself and he got stuck here. This door was locked and the guy with the machete hit him and he just bring his hand like this, and which hit it on his fingers and the fingers fell down around here.
As the young man ran for his life, boxes of stolen cigarettes were piled into the car.
The worker did everything he could to escape. Even after his fingers were chopped off, he managed to climb over this fence to get help from the neighbours. He stayed with them until the attackers left. He then returned to the shop to call his boss.
And when I saw him, like, he was totally fainted and passing out and not able to talk and walk, and he's in the hospital.
These blood splatters are evidence of the violence here. Police were on the scene when the distraught owner arrived.
The finger in the plastic bag thing, and the police gave it to the ambulance and they took it with them.
This neighbour heard the screams and rushed to help, putting his own life at risk.
Got injuries on his chin and on his leg, but he's doing all right. He's a brave man. He came to rescue.
This dairy has bollards, steel gates, panic buttons, and even a fog cannon activated by the worker as he fled. But none of it put off the thieves.
My main thing is like request to government to take some actions and make some harsher punishment for these people.
His biggest concern now is supporting his injured worker.
He worked for me almost three years, and he's like my younger brother, and I'll do whatever I can do for him.
Police are still looking for the attackers, while the injured worker remains in a serious condition in Waikato Hospital.
Well, Te Anua is with us now live from the shop. Certainly, Te Anua, it looks like a very scary and frightening day for the owner and the worker. You've been learning more about the victim.
Hi, Melissa. Yes, the worker was a well-known and well-loved member in this community, and people have just been pouring in all day to deliver flowers, to deliver well wishes, to ask how he's doing as he recovers at hospital. The community is understandably horrified at what's happened. I spoke to a mother earlier who said she regularly brings her children to this dairy. She's just grateful they weren't caught up in this attack too. I've also learned that the worker and his partner are expecting their first baby soon. So this has just come at a terrible time. Everyone in this community simply hopes something can be done to prevent further crime like this from happening in the future.
Ngā mihi nui. Thanks, Te Anua.